Oba talk me, he say, today is the 28th of May 2021. My name is Ambassador Matthew Biki Waifo, and I'm speaking to you from my cassava farm in rural Benin City, Edo State. The time now is 5:15 p.m. in the evening. Today, we receive with good news and joy the Supreme Court judgment in favor of Governor Godwin Obaseki. The summary of it is simply this: Obaseki never forged any of his certificates. The case was judged in his favor, and the APC were fined 1 million naira as costs. Glory be to God. Congratulations to His Excellency Governor Godwin Ogegase Obaseki. Congratulations to His Deputy Philip Shaibu, to the Secretary to the State Government, Osarodion Ogie, and all members of Obaseki's team. Congratulations. Congratulations also go to the PDP for being resolute and standing with the governor throughout all the travails. Now, my people, over 10 cases were brought against Obaseki, and he has won all the cases. And this latest one, the Supreme Court now puts into the burner forever all cases against Obaseki concerning the last election that was held in September 19, 2020. We will now have time, he now has time to face the job of executing his mega agenda to move Edo State forward. Forward ever, backward never. And I just want to stress here, as I've always told people, all the cases against Obaseki from October last year after the elections, I told my followers and I told supporters of Obaseki that they were storms in a teacup. And that is what they turned out to be. Glory be to God. I also said I knew the cases will not go anywhere because God speaks to me. According to His word in Isaiah 44:26, if I send any of my prophets on any message, whatever they say, we come to pass. Everything I've said about Obaseki's cases have come to pass. And I'm a fulfilled man today. Glory be to God. I'm not a pastor. I don't own a church. I'm not a soothsayer. But God speaks to me. And I give Him all the glory for confirming His word. Ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters in the diaspora, I greet you all wherever you are. And I say it is time for us to support this government to move Edo State forward. I also want to thank President Buhari for being resolute in standing and defending what he said October 10, 2020, that he will not stand aside and see political gladiators and confusionists try to compromise the judiciary in their own favor and truncate the will of the Edo people. He said the Edo election was one of the hallmarks of his government. And I want to thank him that despite the pressures that were put on him this time, that he never broke his promise to Edo people. He stood firm and allowed justice to prevail. Glory be to God. Thank you. Kudos to you, President Buhari. I criticized Buhari about the running of Nigeria. But you see, when a man does good, you should acknowledge it also. Buhari this time did good, so I'm acknowledging it. And finally, is it not clear to all and sundry that, as I used to say, Obaseki is divinely appointed to take Edo State from and liberate Edo State from poverty, ignorance, agberoism, kidnappism, and bad governance, and godfatherism. It is clear. This man is divinely appointed. So can you please Leave him to run the state now, so that we can begin to see the fruits of democracy. Obaseki, I repeat again, is divinely appointed. No weapons raised against him or his administration will succeed. The Supreme Court has proved again that the tsunami that hit the opposition APC and their never candidate, Pastor Ize Iyamu, is something that has mesmerized them and continue to mesmerize them. Please, I now say, elections are over, the court cases are over, it is time to develop our state. So I'm calling on everybody to support this government. Thank you all for listening to me. This is a short broadcast. God bless you all. God bless Edo State. God bless all supporters of Obaseki. I will now sit and know that good news is on the way. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Amen.